maybe you can make a new website for free, and you can put a link at the bottom. Then people are going to see how good the website is. They go to your website, you get lots of new customers, and then you will be rich. What do you say?
Wow, that sounds like a really good deal. But I think I have a better one. How about... no.
Welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman. I'm a game developer. And today we are going to make our character go inside one of these houses. Okay, so let me show you the demo. Here it is. You can see that this is the same file we used for the scrolling tutorial. Let's go inside this house. Put inside the house. Let's go back out. Here we are. Let's go back in. Without knocking. And the guy is like, can I help you? And you're like, no, I'm just looking around. You do realize this is someone else's house. Right, so I'm just gonna leave. Okay, so let's open the example file, which you are going to find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. You can make games with the free version, but if you decide to release your games commercially, there is a link down below where you can download the paid version. Okay, so let's go over the assets. I'm going to double click on my main character. You can see that I have a walking animation and a stop animation, which is just one frame. Now, this is the file from the scrolling tutorial, so there is not much new except for this object here, which is just a regular active object. Now, in the storyboard editor, you notice that we have two frames. Let's go to frame two, and you can see that this is the inside of the house. I also have another red active object here. This is just a picture. Okay, so let's get started. You can see that this is the same map from the previous example. If you run this frame, you can see that the scrolling still works. Okay, but the collision with the door doesn't work anymore. Let's go to the editor. Here it is. You can see that I have 5 events already. Let's enter a new one. If our character is overlapping the red block while the user is pressing up the up key, all we have to do is change frames. Jump to frame 2. Let's try it out. There is our sensor. Press up. And you can see that we are in the house. Let's go to frame 2, go to the editor. Let's do the same action. If it's overlapping the red box while the user is pressing the down key. Then we jump to frame 1. Try it out. There's the house. This works fine, but our character spawns right where we started. We want our character to spawn here. So when we're inside the house, at the start of the frame, we change our global value. Set the global value A to 1. Back to frame 1. Start of the frame. If global value A is equals 1, then we change the position of the character. Change position. Somewhere around here. We're gonna change the direction of the object to down. Let's try it out. Go inside the house. Let's go back out. And that worked fine. Let's make this object invisible at start. Same as this one. And now we need to create the fade effects. Now to do the fade effects, all you have to do is select one from here. Fade. I'm going to make this one for 1.35 seconds. You get the preview here. Notice that you can select all kinds of different transitions. Straight out. Let's walk up to the door. Push up. And there is our fade effect. Now we need one for coming out. Let's add a fade in transition. 1.35. Straight out. Go inside the door. That works fine. And that works not too bad. Now you can add one for coming in. Fade again. Make it short. Fade in. and fade out. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't like the video, give it a thumbs down. Don't forget to check out my other channel, the Sparckman Vlog. Subscribe to the channel. I try to post videos almost every day. Follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now. Right, so it's just coffee time. What time is it?